Welcome, friends. Welcome back to the kitchen. Welcome back to Sunday morning and the Old Cookbook Show. Today we're going to do another recipe out of this cookbook. It's called the Picayunes Creole Cookbook. It was published in 1910 by the Daily Picayune, a newspaper in New Orleans. And it has a lot of really interesting recipes in it. And it's written in a tone in 1910 that they want to bring back forgotten Creole recipes. And they already see that their Creole identity is being eroded by the larger or greater American identity. As you see, I've got a lot of recipes here that I've marked that I want to do over the next year. Today, I want to start with something really simple because I love waffles. I want to do potato waffles. Now, this is a yeasted waffle recipe, so I'm going to start out with some yeast in a little bit of warm water just to dissolve it. Now, the recipe itself asks for cake yeast or fresh yeast, which I don't have or don't have access to easily at this point. So I'm just going to use some dry yeast and I'm going to rehydrate it. And I would normally just rehydrate it in whatever liquid I'm using in the recipe, but dry yeast doesn't rehydrate very well in milk. So I'm going to do it in a little bit of water first. Now, this is a potato waffle recipe, and I assume that it's a way to use up leftover mashed potatoes from last night. So I've got some mashed potatoes here, and these are just potatoes, potatoes alone, no seasoning, no milk, no butter. To that, I'm going to add some flour and the milk. And we'll just mix that together. So this is definitely a recipe to use up leftovers, and the little bit of preamble in the book about waffles is that they are delightful at any time of the day. So it wasn't necessarily a breakfast, something that you would eat at breakfast. It says you could eat them at lunch, you could eat them at tea time, you could eat them at dinner, pretty much any time of the day that you would want to eat them. So continue mixing this with the milk. Last of the milk. And I think at this point I'm also going to start stirring in the water and yeast. Now that this is all mixed together, I'm supposed to put a cover on it and leave it to rise for 2 hours, just at room temperature. So I'm going to leave it sitting here, and we'll come back and I'll see you in a couple hours. A couple of hours have gone by, and with a batter this loose, I wasn't really expecting much of a rise, but it has risen quite a bit. And it smells nice and yeasty, smells like it's supposed to. So the next operation is to take 2 eggs, and I am just making half of a recipe. I didn't need that many waffles. So I'm only going to use 2 eggs instead of the 4 that the recipe calls for. And I'm supposed to beat them up a little bit and then mix them into that batter, put the cover back on and leave it on the counter for another half hour before we cook them. Okay, so I'm going to pour this in, and I don't do a lot of yeasted waffles, so I don't know how much rise we're going to get. Be very careful with filling. And I probably overfilled. I always overfill. Let's see what happens. Okay.
Hey, Glen.
Hey, Jules.
Hey, friends.
These are not pretty.
No, for a no-stick pan, you seem to be struggling with whatever's going on there.
There's no fat in these waffles.
Okay.
And there's a lot of potato, which makes them...
Potato?
Oh, yeah. Ooh, that one came out. That one came out kind of nice. So,
should we put another round in just to...
Yeah. Oh, that one came out good, too. Maybe...
First round. It's like the first pancake. Apparently, it's just not going to work out for us. I guess it'll come to the taste.
And I did overfill last time, so I overfilled again. And I know everyone's going to tell me, why don't you measure it?
Yeah. This is one more step.
Yeah. There we go. Okay. Lid down. Potato waffles. No sugar in them at all. And I imagine they could be...
Well, they're very squishy and soft.
Yes, and they've got that fried potato smell.
Yes, they do.
That's interesting.
Yeah, because they don't, they kind of have like a potato, like they have a fried potato flavor to it.
Mm-hmm.
But the texture's really weird, right? Because it's
mashed potato texture. The inside is mashed potato texture to me.
Yeah. And I think I'm fascinated by it. By a handful of reasons.
It's not stopping me from shoving this in my mouth. Like, there's no tomorrow.
You do like fried potato things, mm-hmm. like, you know, mm-hmm. hash browns and all those things. Mm-hmm.
Okay.
So, I'm not sure, though. I'm not sure about them.
I'm digging them, and I'm thinking of all the things we could do with them. There's very little salt in them.
Mm-hmm.
There's very little other flavoring. So you could take them sweet, but you could more easily take this in the direction of savory. A little bit more salt, some pepper, even some hot pepper. You could put in some savory herbs
mm-hmm.
and really ramp this up. And this would be a great pancake for chicken and waffles. A great waffle for chicken and waffles. So fried chicken with this. Because mm-hmm. then you've got that potato flavor that's sort of bubbling under, but it's a waffle and it looks really cool.
I feel like, though, and it kind of is reminiscent of a series we did years and years and years ago where we made all sorts of things.
In the waffle
in
iron.
In the waffle iron. Yeah. Like cookies and it's like someone just said, you know,
yeah.
I've got potatoes. Mm-hmm. I don't need to fry them up. But these were yeasted.
Mm-hmm.
So that kind of throws a twist to it. I wonder what they'd be like if they weren't yeasted.
You could definitely do it without the yeast. Baking powder, because there's nothing acidic in here that would make the baking soda rise. So baking powder would change it. And you're not getting any yeast flavor
mm-mm.
at all. Okay. Bit of a weird one.
Yeah.
Bit of a weird one. I'm kind of digging them, and
I can
see
where... potential.
Yeah, I can see where you can take this. And it's definitely... positioned in the book as a way to use up leftovers to the next day. So, thanks for stopping by. See you again soon.